grades of high school in a week or so, next week, Justin and Matthew. And then it will be off to college, and that's such a beautiful thing. So it's going to be up there in Andrew, so I have Olivia, I have an eye on it for you. Yeah, we'll just actually get to keep an eye out for Matthew. Just to make sure that you know, he stays in line. We love Matthew. We're going to miss Matthew. Justin is also going to be going off. And it's going to be sad just to see them go. It's a part of life. It's a necessary part of life, man. It's a necessary part of life where you grow up and you reach that stage. I see Ian as a very, very proud dad. I'm thinking he's just waiting for the kids to go. I don't know what that smile is all about. It's a very pleased smile. It's a proud smile. Okay, it's a proud smile. But we're so happy for those achievements, great achievements. It's a part of life. And as a church, we rejoice with you when you are, doing what it is you're doing and getting your achievements. You know, also the Elkham family. I'm not quite sure if today, did say probably 2 weeks time or so, like these last Saturday. I want to make sure if I'm there again when you leave, it's okay. They've been such an integral part of this church for so long, part of the backbone really of this church. On tiring service, they just touch lives in different ways, and we're going to miss them so much. Sister Amelia, I was telling her this morning, and she said, "No, I don't think you really miss me." But yes, we as a church family, we're going to miss you guys. So much. We hug. I don't know, words can express. And also those who have left us, we are so heartbroken. But you know, that's a part of life. And while they go, we know that others are going to come and share the fellowship and joy with us. So happy to see the love of my life, Lady Olivia. Is here today. When she's here, my heart is full of joy. It's full of joy to see you two, Pastor Shane and Karina. It's really good to see you guys. But it's such a beautiful thing. God continues to bless us, and we continue to share together our lives in ministry wherever we go. This weekend is a very big weekend. It is Memorial Weekend. One of the things we want to do as a church is not just to have our worship and fellowship by ourselves, as if we are just in a vacuum by ourselves. We live in the world. We do live in the world. We live here in America, where this weekend it is Memorial Weekend. And so my message is tying into the Memorial Weekend theme of those who have done great things for this nation. In the Bible, those who have done great things for God's people. And the question for us is what it is that we are sacrificing and doing for our brothers and our sisters. We have a part to play too. When the world looks back, our loved ones look back in years to come and look back at our lives, what will they see as we look back at those who have served this country, served God's people? What do we see when people look back at us in years to come, Sister Boylett? What will people see? What will we leave behind? What is a legacy that we as a people, as a church, what are we leaving behind as we do what it is that God has called us to do? I want to thank those who have participated in the service thus far, and I want to turn your attention to the book of Esther. The book of Esther, the passage of scripture that was read earlier, our scriptural meditation book of Esther. Nice to see you, Shakira. And Mr. Jeremiah, nice to see you too. chapter 4, verse 10 through 17. Barbara, so happy to see you too. Thank you, Barbara. So glad to see you. The book of Esther, verse 10 through 17. The Bible says, "Then Esther spoke to Adash and gave him command to Mordecai for the king's servant and the people of the king's provinces, know that any man or woman who goes into the inner court of the king, who has not been called, he has but one law. This law is to put all to death, except the one to whom the king holds out the golden scepter, that he may live. Yet I myself have not been called to go into the king these 30 days." This is Esther speaking. "So they told Mordecai Esther's words. Verse 13, "And Mordecai told them to answer Esther, 'Do you think in your heart that you will escape in the king's palace any more than all the other Jews? For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?' Then Esther told them to reply to Mordecai, 'Go, gather all the Jews who are present in Shushan and fast for me, neither eat nor drink for 3 days, night or day. My maids and I will fast likewise. And so I will go to the king, which is against the law. And if I perish, I perish.' So Mordecai went his way and did according to all that Esther commanded him." Please bow your heads with me as we pray. Gracious God and our loving Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your words. As we open your words, we pray that you open our hearts, that there is a message every single time we open your word. Your word is life to us as a people. We love you so much. We love the words that you give to us on a daily basis, on a weekly basis. Every Sabbath we come, we open the word, we discuss from the word. We share from the word, because the word is life. The word is Jesus himself. I am the word. So today, oh God, we pray that you bless us, that you draw close to us, that, Lord, you will do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. And as we look at memorial and we look back at those who have served this country, those who have served God's people, we look at ourselves and see how we serve. And when people look back at us years from now, especially our loved ones, who knows, what will they say of us? Oh God, we pray that our service will be acceptable in your sight. We pray, oh God, that you will work through us in mighty ways, in whatever ways, small ways, wherever you place us. We are open for the working of your Holy Spirit in our lives. We don't want to tell you what to do, how to do it, because you are God and God alone. And Lord, all we want is for you to come into our hearts, to lead us into places where you want us to be. And Lord, just help us to serve. If we have to stand up, help us to stand up, not be silent. But Lord, help us to be wise, especially in these last days. Thank you so much for hearing. Thank you so much for answering, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I want to speak to you in the next few minutes on the subject, "If I perish, I perish. If I perish, I perish." Some people are simply forgetful. Some people are just like that. They forget, and they're forgetful just about everything. Some people, as they get older, grow older, things seem to just slip their minds. They just can't quite remember. They're not as sharp as they used to be. When I was in school, exam time, you always want to take all that you can get in your mind just to make sure you remember all the stuff that you're trying to either study really hard to understand or just simply cram to pass an examination. And one of my friends once said to me, "Man, if you want to remember, you got to take supplements to remember stuff." So he was loading up himself on all these kind of supplements because he says, "Man, if you really want to remember stuff, you need to take supplements." And he gave me one called Ginkgo. I think most of you would know that one. It says that it's very good. It helps you to remember stuff. And I started to take Ginkgo. And I was taking Ginkgo and I realized something. I was taking Ginkgo to remember, and I was not remembering to take Ginkgo itself. And that was just crazy. And our lives get busy and we tend to forget things. Monday is Memorial Day. It's a day of remembering. Many people seem to forget what Memorial Day is all about. For many, it's a time for picnics. It's a time when you take out all the balls and you're going out to play games. It's the first big day for many people to go by the lake and to do some fishing. It's kind of social. It's kind of picnic. That's what you think of when you think about Memorial Day. It is all of that and more, but the reason for the holiday is so important. It is a day to stop and honor and remember those who have given their lives. Remember those who have given their lives so that we can have picnics and that we don't have to worry about anything like suicide bombers, and we don't have to worry. We can just enjoy and live in freedom and live in this liberty that we are experiencing. And as a church, as a people, it's one of the things we want to start doing is to partake in Seventh-day Adventists, not just to have church and to do what it is that we do while the world is doing something else. They are remembering. And we as a church, we are saluting our heroes. And we remember their dedicated service to this nation. And in our text this morning, we find an entire memorial feast that is named in honor of an act that has saved an entire nation. I don't know if you know or heard about the Feast of Purim, which was instituted on this act of Esther to think that its very, very, very beginnings of this great act that Esther did, it had very, very simple beginnings, humble beginnings. It starts innocently in a ballroom where King Xerxes of Persia is displaying his power and his majesty and his might. And in the midst of this display of his power and majesty of might, they're drinking and they're partying. The Bible says pretty much that Xerxes partied like a rock star. And at the end of this week, he made a request, a very unusual request, Debbie. He sent for his wife, Vashti, who was very, very beautiful. And he said to Vashti, was just sent to his by his maids, and he said, Vashti, I want you to come and display your beauty to all the princes and all the noblemen. The only thing I want you to do is to wear only a crown. So Vashti is supposed to come out, and Vashti is supposed to display all of her beauty, and all Vashti is supposed to be wearing is just simply a crown. Now Vashti is not having any of this. It's in the Bible. It's really there. It's really there. The king is saying to his wife, a husband saying to his wife, I want you to come and display yourself. This is how I'm showing how powerful and how majestic and how mighty I am. Where I can just take my wife, and she's supposed to come and display herself in only a crown. And Vashti would have none of this. Vashti thought the request was ridiculous, and she decided that I'm not going to have any part of this. The kings, I say, a big king, amen, for Fusha, who are not going to be displayed, Michael. So don't you ever try displaying Fusha. The king, the princes, and the noblemen, listen to this. The kings, the king, the princes, and the noblemen, they were outraged. How is it that a wife, how is it that a woman could disobey her husband and the queen disobey the king? They were outraged, and so the king consulted with his counselors, and they all agreed. That's just something crazy. I mean, nobody would dare to say, you know what, you know, maybe she has a point. Maybe we got over, we went a little bit over, we drank too much. Maybe in the midst of all of that, we just went. The men who sat there said, Vashti is rude, she's out of place. And you know what, man? They said, man, get rid of this woman. Can you imagine? And the king listened. And the decree was made throughout all of the Persian Empire, and all the young ladies of all the corners of the empire were to now bid for the throne. It is here that Esther comes into the picture. It is here that we see Esther entering the picture. You see, when God is leading you, come on, I'm going somewhere. When God is leading you, you don't come in the picture before time. You come into the picture at the right time. You have to understand that when God is doing when God is leading you and God is doing what he's doing, you don't necessarily have to be in the picture to be in the picture. But God is going to bring you in the picture at the right time. At the right, you don't have to manipulate anything. You don't have to move this or move that. All you got to do is just to wait upon the Lord, because the Lord that we serve is a faithful God. And in due time, God is going to bring it to pass. God says, before you were conceived in your mother's womb, I had a plan for you. Before you were born, I had a plan for you. And so she comes into the picture at the right time. And you have to understand that even though you don't see what you're expecting to see, that in this great plan of God, somewhere along the line, God is going to insert you at the right time. And let me tell you something, when it's your time, nobody can stop you from going where it is that God is leading you. When God is, listen, God is a person who decides when it is your time.